gave it more than 50 articles. It took between 4 and 6 hours to give us the answer. Boy, how times change. Although this is social media, pretty much all of them. I mean, I picked this. It goes to show how my children had a misspent childhood. There's you guys. And there's all these robots sitting in the background, all reading the same stuff. But really what we feel we've achieved with Glide Intelligence is to really bring fourth generation. Unfortunately, I was there for generation one, so I don't get away with being questioned about being 21 in bars anymore, believe me. But the key difference, and this actually on Monday was, I think, the comment I made, which certainly got the most applause, was we've spent the last 2 years, and I've spent probably the last 32 years, building these tools, basically so that you people don't have to worry about them. It's not always about, the end result is not so much about the tool, it's about the person in front of the screen. It's about empowering them, allowing them to make decisions and to extract meaning. We've actually looked, as Marshall has said, is we look at natural language, so away from keywords, because let's be honest, when was the last time you started a conversation when you got here there, and everyone was talking keywords to each other? No, we use phrases, we use sentences. And as you get into social media, the one thing that we find where a lot of the previous attempts, and even some of my previous attempts would have failed on this, is that social media doesn't actually use recognisable language a whole lot. You've got little graphics, you've got little squiggles, you've got little winks, you know, all this sort of stuff. You've got to be able to put this in and make a contextual judgment about it. So the first thing we did was to try and sort of get a system so that the answers actually make sense to the person using the system rather than just benchmarking it against some sort of academic performance metric. And I mean, down at the bottom of the deliverables, there's a lot of talk about real-time analytics. Speaking as a mathematician, I can tell you it's a logical nonsense to talk about anything happening in real-time. So what we do, though, is we talk about right-time. Right-time for us means that if a news item hits a website or a publication goes live, probably maximum duration latency in the system is about 2 minutes, and that includes all the analysis and all the metrics required. So it isn't real time, but it's damn quick. The other thing, and this is one of my hobby horses, is for too long you people have been presented with the notion that in go the results, out come your answers, and you go, well, where did this answer come from? And this nice opaque black box in the middle, and you can kick it, you can hit it with a hammer, you can go back to the vendor and ask them, you still aren't going to get the answer. So we took it out and actually made sure that of all of the metrics which are actually in Glide Intelligence, you can actually drill through to see exactly where everything came from. Now, you're not going to want to do that every single time you run a piece of analysis, but it's very, very handy when somebody says, you sure about that answer, to say, yeah, look at that, that's where that answer came from, that's why I'm sure it's correct. This is our sort of traditional sort of dashboard. Now, a couple of things I'll sort of highlight is you can stream your news in, but you can also segment it. I mean, one of the things that Glide Intelligence specializes in is allowing you to be an individual. So you've got my news and latest news, but you've also got a need-to-know box and top stories, and you can actually annotate those with comments so that, I don't know, if one of you actually makes an observation of, you know, a story is just absolutely fantastic, you know, everything we wanted to see in an article, you'll write a little note and append it so that all of your colleagues are going to see and have their attention directed to it. You'll notice that we traffic light the material as it comes through, so that as these things are appearing, at least you know whether they're good, bad, or indifferent from your perspective. And you can, as Marshall pointed out, one of the things that we've put in is the ability to shift the perspective around, so you can have a look at issues from different points of view to see, you know, there are opportunities you're missing, and there are issues which are a little bit clearer. These dashboards, you can create them, customize them, and when I say create and customize them, you can do it as a person, as a department, or as an organization. So you can, if you need consistency, you can enforce it. If you want individuality, you can actually create your own. And the system very carefully keeps track of who's doing what, so that nobody gets lost. Now, each of these stories is the first sort of being dealt with in the black box territory. As you click through, the first thing it will actually tell you is, the machine will generate a summary. It will give you your some of your data. You've got your circulation, your ABE calculations. You've got a link button there, but also it will say, I mean, you've got here the products, the company, and the topics that were associated with this particular story. So you don't always have to read all the way through these stories to figure out, yeah, what's that one about? And again, it tells you how many components or sentences or phrases within the story, you know, have a particular tonality with respect to you. We've got one here with a few more in, but as you click on those, actually bring up the individual text. And again, as Marshall pointed out, we've actually put a feedback loop in, and we did it quite deliberately. I mean, the obvious thing people would think is, yes, they put that in so that we can correct mistakes on the machine. And the machine will make mistakes. I will be the first to stand up here and say, you're never going to get 100%. It's a logical impossibility, even when you consider social media and dynamic slang and irony and the way people talk about stuff. We, incidentally, are benchmarking at the moment at article level accuracy around about 95%. It will actually creep up a little bit in the first 2-3 months that you're using it by either you correcting it here. The other thing is that it uses, this is one of the ways that we actually put the context in the system. Even if the language analysis is correct, it may have a different meaning for you. So it may say, Barclays lays off 300 people, and that's a negative statement, and you're thinking, I'm not Barclays, it's not negative for me. So you can change that. And the critical thing is the system is looking at the changes, it remembers them, and it feeds them back in, so that over time, the idea is that the view you get becomes more and more aligned to what it is that makes actual sense to you. Again, rather than have me stand here and say, this is the best semantic analyzer in the world, I'm much more interested in saying, can you actually get it to give you the answers that actually make sense to you? This is one of the ways that we've actually allowed that to happen. If you really don't believe the system, you can actually drill through, obviously. And I mean, Glide Intelligence at the moment coming to market, the drill through could be a radio broadcast, print media, including the NLA restricted content, ordinary print journals, online news and blogs, and I'll talk a bit more about social media in a moment. So when you've got your data, you've got all kinds of different filters that you can actually select, create charts, and the nice thing here is you've got some save buttons and some export buttons. The export is because one of the things that we heard from a lot of companies was, yes, okay, I like this chart, I can put it in a report, but I actually want to aggregate it with our CRM, with our Salesforce, with something else. So can I just have the numbers and I can put them into another platform? So we've made that possible. You just click at the bottom and it says what format you actually want this data in. But the other thing is you can save it as a template so that rather than having to do a whole load of selections the second time round, you just say, oh, that was the one I did last week. Click on that and it will remember all of the actions you did and just redraw the chart.